giving to me thy great salvation, so full and so, so free. And now, let the weak say I am strong.
Falling in love with Jesus, oh, falling in love with Jesus, falling in love with Jesus. I wanna save you. I wanna heal you, but that's not my job. I wanna pick you up above the ground and lift you high.
So let's discuss how to find blues scale, and not just find them, be able to sing them. And the next level will be able being able to add them to your singing, because that's the top level, and it's actually been my desire a long time ago to be able to sing at that level. But this time last year, I couldn't even find them, and even when I hear them, I couldn't even repeat what I heard. And I've been practicing real hard, and I'm sure you remember this singing I did, I posted about some days ago. And actually it also inspires some awesome chords, so I decided to play to it. Yeah, and you should be able to sing without accompaniment like piano or any other instrument and stay on key when you finished. And to take it to the next level, this kind of singing doesn't really help much, because you have to veer off the normal scale, which is like the major scale, and go into all these weird notes, you know, and that's the blues notes, and still be able to come back to the major scale and stay on key at the end. Well, I sang it without the piano, and I just tried it out, and I found out that I was on key. Amazingly, I was on key. So who said practice doesn't make you better? Practice sure does. The first time it will seem as if, like, will I ever get there? Remember, if you're driving, remember how it was when you started learning. It's the same thing. So if you practice with singing, it doesn't matter how hard it may sound at first or how difficult. If you keep doing the same thing, practice a couple of minutes every day, definitely you'll be better off weeks after than when you started. So let me play some chords to this, and you see what I mean.
Almighty God, I bless your name. Holy One, yeah, I worship you, for you are God all by yourself. You are God all by yourself. Oh no, you are God all by yourself. For you are God all by yourself. You are God. You are God all by yourself. You are God. You are God all by yourself.
Yeah, so that's it. As you could hear, I went into even chromatic scale. Chromatic scale is when everything is involved. So it's not like the normal do re mi fa sol la ti do. There are some notes there, like when you go from top to bottom, is so you go do ti te la le so si fa mi me re ra do, or do di re ri mi fa fi sauce la latino. So I went that part, I went God, I think that's where I went God. Okay, I'm not really gonna talk about the chords right now because this is a singing class, okay? So I just went down the chromatic scale with the same notes. So I went. Then ended with diminished and then return home. Okay, so basically, you need to look out for some certain notes when you're singing blues. You want to add blues to your singing, and that is not the, that's not the do re mi fa sol la ti do. There's a note there, like when I went ba, so we have the normal mi re do te, and that's what I did there. Okay, and this is again the reason why you need to know your solfège, because it's gonna help you a lot to actually see where the notes are and to hit and get it, not hit and miss most times. You hit and get it. Okay, so let's listen to the whole song again.
Almighty God, I bless your name.
So here it's still normal, okay?
Holy One, yeah, I worship you, for you are God all by yourself.
You notice how I end it with diminuendo, fade it at the end. Diminuendo is the opposite of crescendo, you know, fade it towards the end, the tail.
You are God all by yourself. Oh, no.
So that's the first one. I went mi re do te. So that te is what added that mode, that feel, that blues feel here. Okay, let's go on.
You are God all by yourself. For you are God all by yourself.
All here is blues notes. It's all based on blues scale. And I don't know if you've watched one of the video I did exercises on blues scale, where if you do it long enough, it will begin to be implanted into your memory bank. And when you sing, it will just begin to come out unconsciously. And that's the first step to learning to master this kind of things. Do te so se fa me do, do te so se fa me do, do re fa fi sol li do. It's way different from, that's the normal one, okay? So that's a run, okay? And it's based on that blues scale. Do te so se fa me do. And I went up again, based on the scale. So I kind of mixed the notes up to make it more interesting.
For you are God all by yourself.
Yeah, that's what you heard there. So let's go.
You are God.
Do mi so do, you are God. So that's a do mi so do, based on a major scale, and got out of the pentatonic scale.
God, you are God all by yourself.
Now that one is interesting because just one note there is what made it blues. You are God all by yourself. You are, so you start with me. Da, 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 da. Okay, got it. So it's mi mi re do la sol si. Okay, this last note is what actually made it bluesy. Just dropped it in and changed the mode. Mi mi re do la sol si F, and that's the notes I ended with. You are God all by yourself. So I went back to the top. Mi re. Now listen.
You are God.
You are God. So that's a fa. God. Now I begin to go down the chromatic scale. I didn't miss a note. So fa, mi, me, re, ra, do, ti, te, la. And that's where I ended it. Okay? So that's where I played that chord. Then diminished and then came home. You see? So let's listen. Listen.
You are God. You are God. You are God all by yourself.
Okay, so yeah, amazing. So at the end, we're still able to keep the key. That's what practice did for me. That's what practice did. And I'm so glad I'm able to come to this level. I'm still gonna still practice a lot more to make it a bit more fluid. But yeah, so far so good. So far so good. So when you practice with knowledge, a lot of you like working hard and you know, you're determined to be able to do something, because I don't believe there's anything that's impossible. Anything is possible unto him that believes. Okay, so same, I believe that I could sing like this. Remember where I was coming from way back then? Wasn't even a singer, zero singer. So to be able to do this today is some achievement for me and something I'm kind of proud of. And it gives me hope that there's more, you understand? There's room for improvement as well. And I can do anything I put my mind to. All right, and some of you, like I mentioned, you practice a lot, but one thing you need to make sure or ensure is you practice with knowledge, you practice with understanding. Both are different things. What do I mean? You know how those singers, when you hear them sing, you go, wow, I'd love to sing like this guy, I'd love to sing like this lady, but how do they do that? So there's no understanding. You know how they sing, and you play it, and
yourself, for you are God.
Perhaps you heard something like this and you want to repeat it, but uh-oh, the notes are not coming. It's coming out wrongly. You see, so you may practice for a long time, you may get it, but it might take you longer than if you understand the knowledge you just got. You got the knowledge that, hey, this guy sing this way, I want to sing this way, but you need to understand the basic, the theory behind it. And that's where TVL comes in, that's where the vocal lexicon comes in, and that's where all this solfège we've been doing, I've been emphasizing, telling you guys, you got to learn this thing, that's where it comes in. So practicing with knowledge and understanding gives you fast results. Practicing working, doesn't matter how hard you work, practicing without knowledge can lead to frustration or slow you down a lot, slow down your progress. So yeah, get practicing and get as much accurate knowledge as you can. And trust me, you're on your way really fast, really fast. Okay, I think that's all I am gonna share on this. So guys, I hope you learned a lot from this, and you can feel free to ask me any question. And if you still don't understand what I'm saying, I know it's a little bit advanced. In fact, it's advanced, all right? This is the kind of level singers like Kim Burrell, they do, like it's no man's business. She sings like this, you know, like it's no man's business. So if you have any question, feel free to ask me. And if you haven't subscribed, make sure you do, okay? Share and like. So I'll see you in the next video. Bye.